I'm going to briefly review how we might use mass balances in a thermodynamic example. In this case, we're looking at a flash where we feed a liquid, and I'll use F to indicate the moles per time coming in, and ZA and ZB to indicate the mole fractions of a binary mixture A and B. So in the flash, what happens, we lower the pressure, we get vapor out. The mole fractions in the vapor phase are represented by Y. V represents the moles of vapor. L represents the moles of liquid, and then the mole fractions in the liquid phase, XA and XB. And so what we're going to use are mass balances equilibrium relations. And so the mass balance that we'll use, the overall mass balance, total amount comes in, leaves, and then the mass balance, say, on component A. So mole fraction of A times the feed. This is the number of moles entering. Mole fraction of vapor phase times V. That's the number of moles leaving in the vapor phase. And then XA times liquid, number of moles leaving in the liquid phase. The other equations that we're going to use, one is we have to specify some things to do this. We're going to specify a relationship between XA and YA. So this is essentially vapor-liquid equilibrium, something, say, from Raoult's law. And I'll specify some values. K is 3.0. Also, we're going to set F equal to 1 mole and ZA equal to 0.4, which of course means ZB is 0.6. Now, the other equations we're going to use are XA plus XB must equal 1, YA plus YB equals 1. And so, in order to solve this, we have, in this case, 5 equations. And let's list our unknowns, XA, XB, YA, YB, V, and L. So I have 6 unknowns and 5 equations. So we need some other information. What I'm going to do is specify L as 0.3 moles. This would come, for example, perhaps from energy balances. But for now, let's specify that. Now we have 5 equations and 5 unknowns. Now, you might think we should be able to write down another equation for component B. Indeed, that's a legitimate material balance. But notice if we take this equation and add it to this equation, we get this equation. So this is not an independent equation. It's a legitimate equation, but it doesn't get us closer to the solution. However, once we specified L, now we can substitute into the mass balance for A. So ZA we're given 0.4. F is 1 mole. So YA I'm going to write in terms of XA using this equation. YA is equal to K, which is 3.0 times XA, and V, well, I specified L is 0.3, so V must be 0.7 moles to satisfy this equation. So I'm going to write V is 0.7 moles plus XA times 0.3 moles. So now I have an equation, only unknown is XA, and if I solve for XA, I get 0.166. Multiply that by 3, I get YA is 0.50. So I solve for the mole fractions, of course I can get YB and XB from these equations. So this is an example of using mass balances along with equilibrium information to determine the conditions, the vapor and the liquid phase, leaving a flash system.